Good day, everybody. Today, I'm talking to Layana Franco, who is the founder and CEO of Swap a Porter. Good day, Layana. How are you?
Hi, Tony. I'm good. Thank you. Thank you for the invitation. And hi, everyone.
Good on you, Layana. Thank you so much for giving us your time, Layana, despite your busy schedule. I'm sure you have a lot more responsibilities at hand. But thank you so much for giving us your time.
My pleasure, Tony.
Are you happy for me to move into our first question?
Sure, absolutely. Let's do it.
Thank you. Layana, can you please share a little about yourself, the place you were born, your education, your passion, the things that you enjoy doing, and one thing that the public might not know about you?
I'm from Brazil. I was born in a small town called Duque de Caxias in Rio. I have a bachelor degree in fashion design back home. And here in Australia, I am studying an advanced diploma in business. And my passions, I'm passionate about learning and sharing my learns with other people. I love influencing people. That's why I opened a channel on YouTube, like you have. It's one of my hobbies. I love editing videos. I also love traveling, exploring other cultures, exploring nature. Yeah, that's what I like. Something about the public might not know about me. I learned English when I came to Australia. So I couldn't speak English at all 3 years ago.
Wow, that's amazing. So in 3 years, you know, you become quite fluent and you're able to communicate pretty well. So good on you, Layana. That's very encouraging. Thank you for sharing that.
No worries.
And Layana, moving on to our second question. Can you please share about your work experiences before you started Swap a Porter? And what lessons have you brought forth from your previous work experiences into Swap a Porter?
Sure. My first job was as a salesperson. And it was not in Brazil. It was in an African country called Angola. I moved there after finishing my bachelor degree. And after 2 years as a salesperson, I was promoted as a shop manager. I was working in a clothing shop, a male clothing shop. And my total experience in Angola was 4 years. My life got kind of steady there. No challenges, nothing happening. So I decided to shake things up and moved to Australia, looking for new opportunities, new challenges, learning a new language. And here, it was really difficult to get my first job because I didn't speak English. Took a while, and I started working as a cleaner and as a waitress. And yeah, the lessons I got from those experiences, first of all, learning by doing. All my jobs, I didn't have any idea how to do them before starting. So I was learning while I was working. And this is something that I bring to Swap a Porter because this is my first venture. And this is what I do. I learn by doing every day. I'm expanding my skills with Swap a Porter. It's been a great experience. And also the job as a cleaner and a waitress, because it's a quite hard work. I guess it gave me resilience and also discipline for the business side. It's not easy to wake up like 4:45 a.m. every day after working as a waitress till late night. So I should be like very focused on what I wanted to achieve. And this is all about business as well.
Excellent, Layana. Thank you for sharing that. And I think that's really good to hear. So before coming to Australia, you've been to Brazil. From Brazil, you've gone to Angola, if I'm not wrong. So that would have actually given you so much of experience, you know, a new culture, new people, new opportunities, you know, to learn and to understand, you know, how they do things differently to how you would have done in Brazil. And then coming to Australia, you know, working as a cleaner and waitress, you know, I myself have worked as a cleaner and in fuel stations. Sometimes I think, you know, people might look at as menial jobs, but it gives you so much of opportunity to interact with people out there, learn the language, learn the slangs, and connect with, you know, the wider community. So that's very positive and encouraging to hear. Thank you for sharing that, Layana. And Layana, moving on to our next question. Can you please tell me, when did you start Swap a Porter? And what was the inspiration behind this entrepreneurial venture?
Swapper Porter started officially in April of this year when I launched my MVP on Instagram. The idea was to bring clothing swaps, the concept of clothing swaps online, so that we could scale up, we could make it available anywhere, anytime. And since I didn't have the skills to build an app or a website, the easiest way was running swaps on Instagram. The inspiration came when I arrived in Australia. After 3 months in Australia, I came here during the winter and only with a suitcase, with winter clothes. And I started getting worried because I didn't have a job and I needed summer clothes. And I asked my friends, so what can I do now? And one of them said, in our building, there is a charity bin in the basement. People put clothes there for charity, so you can have a look and see if you can get anything there. So I went to the bin and I was shocked when I saw all those amazing clothes in great state. And I was like, seriously, people are throwing away those great clothes? In my country, we would never do that. In my country, we don't have op shops as we have here in Australia. We just use our clothes till they thread up, they fall apart. So I was shocked, especially because I'm a fashion designer. And after studying English, I wanted to keep going with my studies in Australia. I started a business, and at the business school, they were asking, so what's the problem that you really care about, you would like to solve? And for me, this was a big problem, because I am from the fashion industry. I have this background, and I felt responsible, like, so I should do something about that. And that's how everything started, to pursue a solution for this problem, and Swapper Porter was the end solution.
Excellent, Layana. That's very encouraging to hear. So you got inspired to start Swapper Porter within 3 months of landing in Australia. And that's awesome, isn't it? Because you're coming with a fresh mindset, you know, you have all these experiences behind you, and then you see this opportunity. And being from the fashion industry, you know, you said, you know, here's an opportunity. I see a pain point. Let me solve this pain point. So very positive and encouraging, Layana. Thank you. Thank you so much for sharing that. And Layana, moving on to our next question. So who are Swapper Porter's customers?
Good question. In the beginning, I would say like anyone like me. But now, yes, I have a target. Are women from 25 to 35 years old living in Australia. They love fashion, but they also love the environment. They are concerned about the planet, climate change. They know that the fashion industry plays a significant role in climate change, pollution. That's why they want to consume and dispose of fashion in the most sustainable way. And they try doing this by consuming secondhand or buying from ethical brands. Yeah. And when it's time to say goodbye to those clothes, they try to find a new owner, a new home for those clothes, so that they can make sure they get a second chance, a second life.
Excellent, Layana. That's very, very positive and very encouraging, because, like, you know, as you said, like when you started off, you thought, okay, the world, you know, everyone out there is my customer. And then you iterated and you realized, okay, I need to narrow down and have a, you know, specific focus on who I am targeting. And I think you have actually chosen a real good market, because young people are more conscious about the environment. You know, they want to really make sure that they, you know, whatever they do is of a sustainable nature. So I think, you know, selecting that as your target customers, I think it's a great, great, you know, way to go about doing your business. So good on you, Layana, and thank you for sharing that. And Layana, moving on to our next question. So how is Swapper Porter different to other organizations or businesses working in the same space?
Yeah, another good question. Many people ask, so what's the value that we are bringing to the table? Our main competitors are eBay, Facebook Marketplace, and op shops. To start with, we bring the possibility to get secondhand clothes for free because the app would work in a freemium model. So you don't pay anything to use the app, but if you want to have access to premium features that will make your experience easier, quicker, and give you some advantages, you should pay a monthly subscription. And those subscriptions, they should be affordable as well. So nothing more expensive that you pay to watch Netflix every month, for example. The other advantage of Swapaport has is that we give the certainty to people that when they swap their clothes, they are actually going to someone else. It doesn't happen when they donate clothes to op shops, when they dump the clothes in that thing, because they can go anywhere. Op shops, they can't handle everything. They can't sell everything. So because I lived in Africa, I know that developing countries get lots of secondhand clothes from countries such as US, UK, Australia. And some people, they are really concerned. They don't want their clothes to be dumped in a landfill in the other side of the world. So we offer this possibility, this advantage. And also we give the experience of consuming secondhand a little bit of fun and edgy, because it's in an online platform. It's fresh, it's modern. And I believe it takes away that bad conception about secondhand clothes that many people might have.
Excellent, excellent, Layana. Thank you for sharing that. And just moving on from, you know, those points you shared. So if someone wants to actually post about a particular cloth they have, so is there any screening process? You know, can someone put any kind of clothes on your platform, or is there any specific criteria they have to meet?
Yes, the criteria, the clothes should be in good state, like no folds. If they are small folds, they should mention that. They should show the photos, what's the problem, because sometimes we are missing a button, there's just a small stain, and people normally, they don't really care, depending on the problem. So the clothes should be in good conditions or having like small folds.
Excellent, excellent. Thank you. Thank you so much, Layana, for sharing that. And Layana, moving on to our next question. So has the current COVID-19 pandemic affected Swapaport? If yes, what have you done to mitigate its effect? If no, how were you able to ride the storm?
I think the effect was positive for Swapaport because it's online and all the clothing swaps parties were canceled due to coronavirus. So I found this gap. So for me, it was very interesting and also had more time to develop the idea, to work on the startup because I am at home at the moment. So I guess the pandemic was good for Swapaport.
Excellent, excellent, Layana. Thank you. Thank you for sharing that. And that's very positive and encouraging to hear that. And Layana, moving on to our next question. So moving forward, what are your plans for your business?
The short-term plan at the moment is to launch a page on Instagram only for local swaps in Melbourne, since we are close to finish the lockdown in October. I want to make people able to meet and swap. Like they swap online, but instead of shipping, because at the moment everyone is shipping, instead of shipping, I want to make them meet because this is the core of the app. And the app is already in the pipeline. I have a tech co-founder and the app might be released next year, hopefully. And I think it's a good idea to have already a community in Melbourne because we want to start from Melbourne and then expand to other capital cities in Australia.
Excellent. Sounds like a very interesting plan. Like, you know, so after lockdown, bring the community, you know, who are using Swapaport together. So probably, you know, they can see each other wearing, you know, their clothes and be impressed or surprised or whatever. and that's interesting. And Layana, moving on to our next question. So, and this would be our last question too. So what are the life and business lessons that you would like to share with someone who is planning to start a business in Australia? So I think you tick a lot of boxes, Layana. One is like, you know, I use the word cognitive diversity. So you were in Brazil, you went to Angola, so you have that experience. You came to Australia, then you worked, you know, as a waitress, as a cleaner. And then within 3 months, like, you know, of landing in Australia, you identified a pain point and then you started a business. So very, very fast in terms of like, you know, the way you organized yourself and did things. So it would be very interesting to hear, you know, what are the life lessons or business lessons that you would like to impart to someone who is on a similar journey like yours?
I think what happened with me, it's the proof that you don't need much to start a business. If I was look all my limitations, I would never start. So I guess what made me do it was that I have this passion, this drive to change something, to have a positive impact in the world. So in my opinion, it's very important that you know very well your why you want to have your business and have this drive that makes you wake up every morning and do what you need to do to get there. And after that, you figure out everything. You figure out money, time, resources, because you know where you want to be. Another thing that's important is build a strong network, because my network is what's making this possible. The network brings everything you need to start your business, all the resources.
Excellent, Layana. Thank you so much for sharing that. So that's very interesting, to be honest with you. So, you know, if for an entrepreneur who's thinking of exploring that space, so why is very important, isn't it? Why are you actually getting into business at the first place? You know, have you identified a valid pain point? And then you said, like, you know, drive, you need to be passionate, because entrepreneurship is pretty hard. You know what I mean? You need to, as you said, you know, when you are working as a cleaner or as a waitress, you need to wake up every day at 4 a.m. So you need to really be consistent, you know, in what you're trying to do. And then I think you said network. That's also such an important thing, especially as an international student. When you're coming to a new country, you know, usually it's very hard to build relationships, you know what I mean, when you land here. So it takes a bit of time and effort. So, you know, looking after your studies, looking after your part-time job, and then, you know, having this passion to have a business and network. So that really needs a lot of passion and consistency and persistence. And as you said, drive. So thank you. Thank you so much, Layana, for sharing your story. And it's very encouraging to see what you're doing with Swap A Porter. I think there is a market for what you're doing in Australia, because as I shared, you know, there are a lot of young people who are really passionate about the environment. You know, they really want to make a change and a difference. So I believe you are on track to do great things in the future. So Layana, thank you so much for your time. I wish you and Swap A Porter the very best. All the best, Layana. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Johnny. And I wish you all the best also in your project, in your channel. And it was a pleasure to talk to you.
Thank you, Layana. All the best.